In this video, I will explain advanced biomechanics of tibio-talar joint, what happens when dorsiflex and plantar flex, and I will explain the biomechanics of this joint as well. But first of all, I will explain the four bones of ankle joint. This is tibia, the big one, which is medial side. This is called fibula, the outside, lateral side. And this, the bump, is called lateral malleolus, lateral because it's outside. And this is medial malleolus. Tibia is medial malleolus. Fibula is lateral malleolus. And this joint, fibula and tibia, is called distal tibial fibula joint. This joint is very important in this video. Then we have talus under the tibia. Tibia and talus and fibula here. And under the talus we have calcaneus. We are not focusing calcaneus this video. I am focusing this area in this video. So what happens in this joint? This joint is controlling dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. Dorsiflexion, plantar flexion happens here, tibio-talar joint. But if you look carefully, the front part of talus is wider. And the back side, posterior side is narrow. Posterior side, narrow. And anterior side is wider. What does it mean? What is so important? When dorsiflexes and tibia covers talus front part, that means the joint surface in between tibia and talus is wider, right? This part is wider. The joint surface, contact surface is going to be wider. What does it mean? It means more supportive surface is here, more stable. This is dorsiflexion. But in plantar flexion, remember the posterior side is narrow. In plantar flexion, the contact surface in between talus and tibia is less than dorsiflexion. In plantar flexion, less contact surface, that means less support. So when this guy is standing, it is dorsiflexion position, right? Dorsiflexed, or walking a supportive leg. Dorsiflexion means more support. But in plantar flexion is less support. What does it mean? Like when people are playing ballet, dance, in plantar flexion position, that means they have less support in this joint. That means more likely to get ankle sprain because this position has less support. And additionally, if person does dorsiflexion, this distal tibial fibula joint, do you remember tibia, fibula, distal tibial fibula joint should open. Fibula should opening up, this is exaggeration, opens, lateral rotation, and it should go up in dorsiflexion. I will say it one more time. Dorsiflexion, in dorsiflexion, fibula should opens up, lateral rotation, and it should go up. I will explain in the rear foot model. Remember, this is fibula, lateral malleolus, medial malleolus, tibia. And we have distal tibial fibula joint, talus right here. When person has dorsiflexion, this is more stable because the surface, joint surface of tibia, talus, tibia is more contact surface, which is more supportive. Plantar flexion, and this is less supportive. And when person does dorsiflexion, this is fibula, fibula lateral malleolus should opens up and lateral rotation and should go up. So in between tibia and fibula, there's membrane called interosseous membrane, which kind of ties up together these two bones. If person does dorsiflexion, this interosseous membrane should have flexibility. So what if this part gets tight? That means person is hard due to dorsiflexion, plantar flexion, because of interosseous membrane in between two bones. Plus, these calf muscles are very crucial for ankle joint movement. So this is it. It was kind of very advanced mechanics, but if you like this video, please like and subscribe my channel.